And in addition to that, as many of you know, the Secretary had previously given speeches behind closed doors to major Wall Street companies like Goldman Sachs, where she got paid $225,000 per speech. And she gave a lot of speeches. Now, here's what I think. If you get paid $225,000 for a speech, it must be an extraordinary speech. It must be mind-blowing. It must be Shakespearean. It must be revealing unlocked sources of knowledge. And I think that if the speech is that great, it should be released to the American people. Let's all sing it. Now, Hillary Clinton says, okay, I will release my transcripts if other candidates release theirs. So I have a dramatic announcement to make right here in Youngstown, Ohio. Are you all ready for this dramatic announcement? I am prepared here and now to release all of my transcripts for the speeches I gave on Wall Street. Here they are! Shh. No transcripts, no speeches. I just wonder why, I don't know, why Wall Street hasn't invited me and offered me $225,000 to make a speech. I just don't know why, but I'll tell you this. If tomorrow my friends on Wall Street want to invite me, I don't need their money, but I will go, and this is what I will tell them. I will tell them that their greed and their recklessness and their illegal behavior brought this country into the worst economic downturn since the Great Depression. I will tell them that their illegal behavior cost millions of Americans their jobs, their homes, and their life savings. And I will tell them, you know, many of these banks, Goldman Sachs and many of the other major ones, Goldman Sachs alone, about a month ago, reached a settlement with the United States government for $5 billion. Do you know that? $5 billion. You know why they reached that settlement? Because they were selling worthless packages of subprime mortgages. Okay? So they reached the settlement for $5 billion. And this is my message to Wall Street. Some kid or person here in Ohio or my state of Vermont gets picked up today with marijuana. That person will have a police record, will have a criminal record for the rest of his or her life. But, if you are an executive on Wall Street and your company, your bank, reached an agreement with the federal government for $5 billion, you know what happens to you? You get a raise in your salary. So I will tell the people on Wall Street to watch out, because we are going to bring back justice to the criminal justice system. What justice is about in America is justice under the law, equal justice under the law. You're poor, you're rich, equal justice for all, including Wall Street executives. Now I want to talk about another difference between Secretary Clinton and myself a profound and important difference that the people of Ohio, the people of Illinois, the people of the entire Midwest knows, as does every American. And that is that our disastrous trade policies, NAFTA, CAFTA, permanent normal trade relations with China, have cost this country millions of decent paying jobs. In Ohio alone, from 1994 through 2015, this state lost 300,000 manufacturing jobs, 31% of its factory jobs. And the key difference between Secretary Clinton and myself is not only did I vote against every one of these disastrous trade agreements, I helped lead the opposition to them. So when it came down to whether you stand with corporate America, the people who wrote these agreements, or whether you stand with the working people of this country, I proudly stood with the workers. Secretary Clinton stood with the big money interests. I was on the picket lines, in the early 1990s, because I understood what these trade agreements were about. You all understand what these trade agreements are about. They're written by corporate America, and corporate America said, why do I want to pay a worker in Ohio or in Indiana or in Illinois or in Vermont 20, 25, 30 bucks an hour when I could shut down in this country, move to Mexico, move to China, pay people pennies an hour, and bring our products back into this country? That is what these trade agreements have always been about. And if elected president, trust me, we are going to change those trade agreements. Since 2001, 15-year period, this country has lost almost 60,000 factories, millions of decent-paying jobs. That's tragedy number one, and it has devastated, as all of you know, communities like Youngstown, Akron, communities all over this great state, but all over this country. So we have lost millions of decent-paying jobs, but I'll tell you the other half of the story that is often not reported. It's not only massive job loss, it is the race to the bottom. Do you know what I mean by that? What I mean by that is that the new jobs that are being created in manufacturing today, and we have some new jobs, that's the good news. Bad news is they pay substantially less than these jobs paid 20 or 30 years ago. So workers are coming in, young workers are coming in, working next to older workers, and yet they're earning significantly less. And you know why that's happening? Because what the trade agreements do is allow employers to say to workers, you got a choice. Here is your choice. Either you're going to accept a major reduction in your wages and in your health care benefits. If you don't like that, that's fine. We're going to China. Those are not the choices that workers in this country should be forced to make. So we tell corporate America, every night you turn on the TV, they want you to buy this car, they want you to buy that product. Well, if they want us to buy their products, the time is long overdue for them to start manufacturing those products here in the United States of America. I'm tired of seeing them creating jobs all over the world while they're laying off American workers. Not acceptable. That is going to end. Look, what thinking outside of the box is understanding where we can go as a nation. You want to talk about jobs? I was in Flint, Michigan a couple of weeks ago. What I saw in Flint, Michigan was literally incomprehensible to me. And after I talked to some parents, I had to go out and give a speech. And it was hard for me to give that speech because I was so shaken. In America in 2016, in Flint, Michigan, children are being poisoned by a broken water system in which people are ingesting lead in their water. In America in 2016. Children are being poisoned, but it's not just Flint. Recent report, Newark, here, all right. Now, I want to ask you this. This is thinking outside of the box. How in God's name, in the richest country in the history of the world, that's what we are today. Why are water systems, why is our infrastructure crumbling while the rich get much richer? That is not what America's supposed to be about. Look, let's be honest. If we were a poor country, if we were a poor, struggling country, what we would be honest about and say, look, it's terrible that our water systems, our wastewater plants, our roads, our bridges, our airports, our rail system is crumbling. We're a poor country. We can't do anything about it. We are not a poor country. But what we have is massive income and wealth inequality, and we have our priorities as a nation absolutely backward. This is what, in my view, we should be doing. We should be investing $1 trillion over 5 years to rebuild our crumbling infrastructure. Water systems, roads, bridges. In my state of Vermont, we got roads that are in desperate need of repair. We got bridges that are in need of repair all over America. This is America. Why the hell can't we rebuild our roads and bridges and our water systems? And when we put $1 trillion over 5 years, we create 13 million decent paying jobs rebuilding America. Now people say, well, Bernie, we need to rebuild our infrastructure, but $1 trillion, that is a lot of money. Where are you going to get the money? I will tell you where we get the money. Right now, you have major corporations making billions of dollars a year in profit. And you know what they do with their profits? They stash their money in the Cayman Islands, Bermuda, and in other tax havens. And at the end of a given year, some of these corporations do not pay a nickel in federal income tax. We're gonna do away with that loophole. We're going to bring in an additional $100 billion a year. And we're going to use that money to rebuild our crumbling infrastructure. That's what we're going to do. Let me also tell you what we are going to do. And again, it is important to think outside of the box. Don't allow the media to decide what you're allowed to think. Right now, we have a public school system in this country which says that we should have free public schools. I went to a public school. My family didn't have any money. That's where we went. It was pretty good schools. Today you have public schools that provide free education from the first grade to the 12th grade, right? That's good. But you know what? the world has changed. The economy has changed. People need more education. Now, 50 years ago, 50 years ago, if you had a high school degree, you were doing pretty good. You had a high school degree in Burlington, Vermont, Youngstown, Ohio, the odds